In 1792, France was fighting for her life against the forces of ancient corruption. And for a few years, her leaders suffered from the most terrible of all delusions. They believed themselves to be virtuous. Robespierre's friend Saint-Just said, "In a republic which can only be based on virtue, any pity shown towards crime is a flagrant proof of treason."
Good news, everyone. I've got it. I know how to solve all of this. The answer? Just do what I say, all the time. If you follow orders and obey the law, then peace, happiness, and joy will follow. Easy, right? Well, that's what the Harmonium believes, anyway. The Harmonium, jokingly referred to as the Hardheads, are Sigil's police force. They have a massive organization across the Outer Planes and an entire planet on the Prime dedicated to their faction beliefs. And those beliefs are order, order, and more order. Control, hierarchy, lawfulness, and an end to war. The Harmonium believe that every sentient creature in the entire multiverse should be brought together into one single governmental philosophical body. See, the Harmonium's goal is its meaning. The simple act of bringing everyone together under peace and brotherhood is the conclusion they want. The Harmonium serve as Sigil's police force. They can be seen patrolling all over the city with their bright red armor, sharp halberds, and magic man-catchers. The man-catcher is a holy weapon of gods in the love domain in Dungeons & Dragons, which is fitting for a group who believe that everyone in the entire multiverse will one day be embraced under their banner. The Harmonium are earnestly trying to help people. Everyone just needs to calm down, relax, and work with one another to build a happy, content galaxy. The city's barracks is the faction headquarters, and that fits their militant nature perfectly. A hardhead goes through tough, boot camp-like training when he joins up. 8 solid weeks of grueling physical labor and constant political indoctrination. The Hardheads are a very physical faction, a band of rough fighters putting the screws to Sigil's enemies. The Harmonium doesn't like people, even other Hardheads, to think too much. Everything is right, the Harmonium is right, and just work on keeping order and soon everyone will know we're right and everyone will be right. They remind me of the current version of the Brotherhood of Steel in Fallout 4. Militant, intolerant, and willing to impose their views on others. The base of operations for the Harmonium is Arcadia, the plane of well-ordered law for the common good. Arcadia is a magical land of beautiful trees, gorgeous meadows, and friendly, happy animals. This enchanted land radiates virtue and kindness. Strangely, the entire plane is lit by a giant sphere, half light and half dark, like part of the positive and negative energy planes fused together with no merging of shadow in between. There is no dawn or dusk. Light comes and goes suddenly. The way this sphere works by only using good or evil without shadow in between is an apt metaphor for the function of the black and white worldview of the Harmonium. Crucially, the orb has placed together light and dark, existing as one, just as harmony is more important than good or evil. There should be no conflict, only fusing of spirit and body. The role of policeman to the wild, multiplanar city of doors is a dungeon master's dream. The possibilities for quests are limitless when you're a hardened gumshoe tracking down Tanari thieves, anarchist terrorists, or crazed bleaker mages bent on annihilating half the clerk's ward because a voice in his head told him to do so. It's no secret that Sigil is a rough place, and many openly flout the law. The Hardheads would probably be fans of the Elvis Costello song, "What's so funny about peace, love, and understanding? What is a cynical bastard thinking and dismiss the notion of working together and bringing hope and peace to everyone? After all, most hardheads are just decent folks trying to help people by solving crimes and stopping wicked people doing wicked things. For all the grandiose talk of liberty by the Chaos factions, the Hardheads are the common man's only defense against evil. And Sigil is filled with crooks, murderers, barmies, and every kind of infernal creature literally from hell itself. A burly young man in plate armor is probably a comforting rather than distressing sight for the vast majority of Sigilian citizens. It may seem loony to think that the entire galaxy will be blanketed by your idea and power one day, but after all, most people in most times do just want to avoid trouble, live their lives, ply their trade, raise their families, and do so without chaos or crime disrupting their simple plans. Despite the explicit forfeiture of freedom, that would be a very attractive goal for huge swathes of the population. Since the countercultural revolution of the 1960s and 70s, it's difficult for us to see the world in this way. The boomer generation has created the modern interpretation of the world as hyper-individualistic, self-serving, pleasure-seeking, and authority-hating. Whether you are left or right, the old-fashioned values of duty, service, and respect for tradition are considered hopelessly out of date. But this is just one society and one era of human history. It would be a mistake to consider human beings naturally predisposed towards liberty and self-interest. Most of history is a story of most people obeying others and following their orders. Definitely appeal to conservative people who want an ordered nation centered on abnegation of your personal desires into the collective will of the people. And this desire can exist in a wide variety of settings, from ferocious young democracies like revolutionary France or America, or totalitarian states like Mao's China. Which brings me to the logical conclusion about the Harmonium. They are extremely totalitarian and likely find their greatest expression in Stalinist Russia or Hitler's Germany.
But the grim years of regimentation have done their work. Now he's a good Nazi. He sees no more than the party wants him to. Says nothing but what the party wants him to say. And he does nothing but what the party wants him to do. And so he marches on with his millions of comrades, trampling on the rights of others. For now his education is complete. His education for death.
When claiming that you are right, it necessarily creates people that are wrong. And what are you going to do about them? The Harmonium was founded on the pleasant prime material world of Ortho. A group of adventurers went out into the land, just like the beginning of all D&D adventures, to rid the country of evil. But they actually succeeded. The entire land, continent, and eventually planet was made free of evil and chaos, or enslaved to law and order, depending on how you want to look at it. The adventuring group named themselves the Harmonium because they brought harmony, if not necessarily happiness, and proceeded to govern the planet. The ultimate dream of the adventuring party is to be heroes by erasing evil, war, and conflict from the world, right? Well, not exactly. The conquest and establishment of an empire over an entire planet ran into opposition. While plenty of this opposition was soundly defeated and welcomed into the empire, a fair number of people just couldn't adapt. Like square pegs in round holes, there really was no place for them inside the perfect society, and something needed to be done. Namely, by ethnically cleansing the planet of all of the races that didn't quite get along with the new order, like elves, pixies, and gnomes. They probably have the darkest backstory of all of the factions, strangely enough, even though they're supposed to be so friendly and nice. The opinion of the Harmonium today about their genocidal activities 5 centuries ago is muted. Most of the time, they simply deny it ever happened. You can play around with that silence to make the Harmonium go in 2 unique directions. First, they can be silent because they are deeply ashamed about what happened and don't want anyone to know the embarrassing truth. They did, after all, allow evil creatures such as orcs and beholders to survive the crusade, but the chaos ones had to go. Something went wrong, and they may feel bad about it. Second, more nefarious meaning, is that the Harmonium plans to extend their campaign of mass murder across the entire multiverse, and wants to quiet any dissent to this aim. Or perhaps there is a tug of war within the Harmonium about both of these plans that never is quite resolved. Any way you want to play should make for life-or-death decisions about the Harmonium's role in the world. One thing the Harmonium stress over and over again is their love of peace. It's an article of faith to the hardheads that peace should be an overarching goal of all living creatures. After all, violence and especially war bring only suffering, stops people from trading, and destroys what has already been built. War cheapens mankind into an object that can be destroyed, wiping out countless souls that all bring their own unique, brilliant perspective to the world. After all, hasn't mankind always been striving to end the struggle to survive? The hopeless, brutal war of animal against animal? Shouldn't the ultimate freedom be the freedom to create without fear of your works being ruined? To create a world where everyone is so happy they won't have any desire to hurt one another? Peace on earth and goodwill towards men is a holy belief for the warriors of order in the Harmonium. However, that's not entirely accurate on a number of levels. First, in order to bring everyone into this perfect harmony, it requires a titanic amount of war. They create a wasteland and call it peace, as was said of the Romans. How much nightmarish destruction and carnage, if not outright genocide, would be the result of this new order? As America found out in Vietnam, sometimes even if a country chooses something bad, it's better to allow them to make their own national mistakes rather than use brute force to change their minds. The Harmonium are a militant faction, and routine use of might to order everyone around is taken as a given by most members. Secondly, who's to say that peace is even a desirable goal?
Perpetual peace is a dream, and not even a beautiful dream, and war is an integral part of God's ordering of the universe. In war, man's noblest virtues come into play: courage and renunciation, fidelity to duty, and a readiness for sacrifice that does not stop at giving up life itself. Without war, the world would be swamped in materialism. End quote. Others will point out that if you decide to try to make war, you know, a thing of the past, what happens to all those people that are in situations where, you know, they're struggling against foreign oppression, for example? Are you going to tell someone they can't free themselves from a horrible oppressor because, you know, violence is bad?
Historians, especially in the past, tend to praise people or groups for bringing together huge agglomerations of people, as if massive collections were somehow automatically better. But was Genghis Khan or Hitler good just because they brought millions of people and huge land masses under one ruler? There is much to be said of periods in history where people were divided and warring non-stop that nevertheless brought great technological, cultural, or political advances, such as the warring Greek city-states of the classical world or the Enlightenment, which took place during almost unceasing war in Europe for a century, or the Renaissance itself and the birth of the modern world took place during 2 centuries of unremitting, pointless violence in northern Italy. But to that point, the Victorian era, when warring in Europe was largely, but not entirely, halted due to international agreement and diplomacy, did result in a meteoric ascent of scientific and societal advancement that in a century dwarfed everything that came before it. And the vast majority of the Earth was under varying degrees of control from a few tiny states in Europe. So maybe the Harmonium had something right about human achievement being linked to peace after all. And of course the Harmonium are violently opposed to the idea of creative destruction. Sometimes I feel you need a historical arsonist to burn down everything that came before you so you can start anew with fresh ideas. In a world of total peace, how can we overthrow dictators or the corrupt? And don't things naturally become corrupt over time, no matter what you do? Don't you need revolution over time? There would be a never-ending static life with everything always in their place, with no possibility to alter anything. But chaos is a strange force that seems to erupt out of the best-laid plans. The Harmonium originally left their homeworld of Ortho because chaos and violence seemed to be creeping into their society. So they decided that their perfect system could not be the cause. The outside universe must be the answer, right? So they reignited their crusade, this time directing it into the outer planes. Whether it's Napoleon or Oliver Cromwell, it's often a factor of new orders to solve internal discontent or disunity by assaulting another country in the name of spreading the revolution. Ortho itself could be a major location in a Planescape campaign and could be presented in a number of ways. Maybe it really is the utopia it appears to be, or perhaps the seeds of revolution could be sown among the populace by a chaotic character who just wants to see the world burn. They seem to believe that people are naturally good and conflict is only the result of disagreement. But that may be wildly untrue, as chaos is an atavistic force that seems to grip and shape things quite a bit no matter what you try to do to control it. Another dark, authoritarian tone to the Harmonium is the notion that disagreement itself is something to be avoided. They want everyone to believe the same thing all the time, and difference is synonymous with deviance. There is a worrying trend in modern America that people who think the wrong thing should be shunned and rejected as morally inferior, their voice unheard because they've gone against the norm, or even rather than reject the norm, reject that they have an obligation to join others in supporting it. The Harmonium's views, just like some modern authoritarians, speak with the smug grin of cloying concern. They're just trying to help, after all. Having two types of hardheads, the good cop who just wants to help and is deeply disappointed in you, and the bad cop who stands menacingly behind, cracking his knuckles. Wrong think and proper think is an integral part of harmony, as in a hive mind where no one may think for themselves. The faction's attitude towards people that are different than they are reminds me of the medieval Christian concept of punishment. Punishments for disobeying the Lord, medieval jurists argued, were not judged exclusively on the seriousness of the crime, but rather on the fact that committing the crime meant you deliberately disobeyed God's commandments and the perfect love of the Christian church. Thus, the punishment was for turning away from God's love and God's word, not for the damage done by your criminal behavior in an objective sense. Using that logic, even the most meager of crimes, like stealing bread, could be equated with blasphemy. You were being punished for choosing to be different, and choosing something else, like your own wants and needs, instead of the rest of the community's common worship. The punishment was for social violation, not for the acts themselves. Naturally, the hardheads only allow lawful characters to join their ranks. They tend to do better if they're lawful good, but neutral or evil characters are just as welcome. Paladins make the best hardheads. Even the Factal himself is a paladin of St. Cuthbert. A paladin, to paraphrase someone talking about Victorian imperialists, is 10% religion and 90% mustache. Aggression, dynamism, and action are all part of the muscular Christianity movement. During the Victorian era, particularly in the United Kingdom, a theory of tough, athletic, action-oriented Christian evangelism motivated a generation of imperialist men. Casting aside the traditional Christian values of charity and poverty, muscular Christianity focused more on converting as many people as possible. In some ways, it was sort of a friendlier, saccharine version of a crusade. The details of dogma and what exactly they believe are tabled in favor of bringing more people under the same tent of belief. Why? Because we're stronger and better, that's why. Fighters and clerics also make good hardheads. Wizards are a bit too reflective and studious, druids are right out for being neutral, and rangers are a bit too individualistic. The most unusual type of Harmonium officer, and also the most interesting to me, would be the hardhead rogue. He could be an informant pressured into service to escape the leafless tree, or a lifelong crook who undergoes a change of heart and devotes himself to law and order for repentance. Having a rogue, the class that seems much naturally opposed to law, become a hardhead sounds really interesting, and it would be fun to explore. Racially, the Harmonium is a touchy issue. Humans and dwarves dominate. There are also quite a few lawful evil races like orcs or Beatazu that can freely join the hardheads. Naturally chaotic creatures obviously can't. Old-school D&D implied that your racial alignment really couldn't change, but Planescape helped to alter that. In theory, any creature can change to any alignment from any alignment, and it's even noted that a creature that was once chaotic evil in the Planescape setting transformed and became a great hero to the Harmonium by going from chaotic evil to lawful good, and is held up as a trophy of what they can achieve. And presumably, that is what the Harmonium intends for them to do once they complete their conquest or peaceful annexation of the universe. But the Harmonium's past involves mass murder of elves, pixies, and other chaotic creatures. That typically puts a damper on elves and others like that joining the group. But maybe that's part of your unique Harmonium build. An elf joins and has to overcome the dark past of the group in his struggle for peace and Sigil. But all is not doom and gloom and seriousness. The excellent Terry Pratchett novels Men-at-Arms and Guards provide examples of comic medieval guardsmen. They could be the basis of a dim-witted, comedy-oriented hardhead who doesn't quite understand the City of Doors or what's going on around him, but has his heart in the right place. The Harmonium has close friends and bitter enemies among the other factions. They form a key part of the triad of order that is responsible for justice in the cage. The Fraternity of Order runs the courts, the Mercy Killers carry out the punishments in the prison, and the Harmonium enforces the laws on the streets. Just because the three factions work together hand in glove doesn't mean it isn't possible to show them fighting. Doctrinal differences between the correct interpretation of order could lead to an interesting campaign. But most of the time the groups are close friends, all interested in keeping people in the cage from killing one another too often. The Harmonium are a bit peery of the more selfish factions like the Bleakers, the Sensates, or the Signers, but they are outright enemies of the Chaos factions like the Doomguard, who want to destroy the universe through entropy. The Chaosatecs, who hate order of any kind, and their most bitter rival, the Anarchists. The most visceral hatred seems to be between the Hardheads and the Anarchists, as the Harmonium is the most material example of the establishment holding people down. The Harmonium doesn't like even considering them as a faction at all, and a prerequisite for most of the Anarchist plans involve violent assaults on Harmonium officers. They go together like oil and water. Once the Revolutionary League even managed to humiliate the Harmonium by infiltrating their command structure so deeply, an Anarch was almost appointed Factal. The Harmonium brings a lot of excellent things to a PC's arsenal. They have a city-wide network of tough lawmen and investigators ready to discover any info you may need. A hardhead character should be expected to know the streets of Sigil, especially a beat they walk as young coppers. They may also know a lot about the city's underworld and how to get information from thugs. Intimidation and diplomacy are definite skills to invest in. Every hardhead has the unique faction ability of the Voice of Command. Based on charisma, they can bellow an order, and it has a spell-like effect on the recipient that will compel them to obey. A tough-talking, hard-nosed, extra-dimensional detective is a great role to take on with tons of possibilities. All of the hardheads are also trained with the use of an extra-planar man-catcher. A mancatcher is a strange weapon that actually appeared in Dark Souls as the weapon of the Titanite demons. What it is a long pole with a clamp at one end. You use the clamp to grab onto someone and take them prisoner. And this was actually used in the Middle Ages, although as far as I can tell, not for law enforcement, but rather to kidnap people, especially nobles that you could ransom off for money later. But this weapon is a special extra-planar one that allows you to prevent creatures that have teleportation abilities that can shift planes, like Githyanki, from leaving the city, so they can't just teleport out of there when they're caught by the hardheads. That can be a really useful tool if you're trying to fight an enemy like that. On the other hand, the hardheads tend to be repressive, withdrawn, and stubborn. Not happy about people speaking their minds, they may be angry and obstructive in a party of adventurers who are happy to break the law if it suits their needs. The organization itself may harm the investigation of one of its own if it gets caught snooping too far. You may be able to play the character like a stereotypical cop who bucks authority and has to fight his own department to get the job done. The Harmonium is also a gleaming red warning beacon to many people, criminal or not, who may be afraid of the police. It may cause them to clam up rather than risk imprisonment. In some ways, the Harmonium, a rigid group of religious evangelicals, causes a lot of the same problems as any paladin character in a group. Self-righteousness, blind devotion to a narrow view of morality, and difficulty accepting aberrations. The Harmonium take a very active and vigorous involvement in Sigil's government. Order and control are their primary concern, and exerting control over the city government is vital to spreading their message. The faction wants everyone to obey, don't stir up trouble, and listen to their speeches. What the Harmonium believe has a strong emotional resonance for Sigil's masses, with the middle class being overrepresented, the upper class being cautiously optimistic, and the working and underclass either suspicious or hostile. The Hardheads are one of the few factions that actively recruit, going out into the world and canvassing for support. Their campaigns extend throughout the city, eagerly bringing the word of peace, contentment, and brotherhood to anyone who will listen. They've even set up a base in the middle of the chaotic, crime-ridden hive, the heart of the enemy's territory. They claim their patrols will radically alter the lives of Sigil's very poor, and bring a new swathe of support from the people it saves from the ravages of crime. In some ways, the Harmonium are like the American right from the Nixon down through the Reagan era. They have an unshakable belief that cracking down on crime is a prerequisite for a successful society. They're pure reactionaries that have no plans to halt the growth of crime in the first place, and implicit in their doctrine is that the system in itself is good and workable. Our perfect American democratic capitalist society can't be to blame. It must be deviant people who create conflict, causing everything to go wrong. Fixing any root problems is impossible, because that would involve a limit to cracking down and admitting problems can't all be solved by halting crime and conflict in the first place. The faction with the most interesting philosophical correlation to the Harmonium is the Transcendent Order. Both of them involve lawfulness, and both seek to create order. However, the Transcendent Order wants inner order and peace and harmony, while the Harmonium wants to shape the exterior world to orderliness. It's a twisted reflection of the Harmonium's goals, an inner-directed harmony with thought and body that will allow them to join with the harmony of the universe, rather than the notion that the outer world being harmonious will allow each individual to join with harmony. This similarity in thought could bring the Hardheads closer to the Order as a misguided cousin of their beliefs, or result in violent rejection because the parallels are a bit too close for comfort. They may be seen as competition in creating a harmonious world through discipline. Because I'm a pretty chaotic person and sympathize with the chaotic factions, I've been really hard to the Harmonium during this little episode. However, if I were to say good things about them, it is really exciting, fun, and interesting to be a sort of cosmic detective that's investigating all sorts of weird crimes. And you're going to be a really cool, fun, and very useful addition to your group. You're going to be going out there and wanting to help people. That is at the base level what most Harmonium people want to do. They're good folks that want to help others stop crime and make the world a better place. I've focused quite a bit on the dark aspects of the group, but ultimately I think they're a great group to play as. They're always going to add conflict because they provide a natural enemy to the chaotic factions. And overall, they really just want to, they have great goals. The road to hell may be paved with good intentions, but they have good intentions. They want everyone to work together and unite in peace, harmony, and love. Hey, just what do you think you're doing? Give me that. What do you... Get off of me. Let me go.
Mr. Edwards, I'm sure.
Come on, anybody you want to go to? I'll come with you back.
Yes, sir.
Back right away. Just pull along. Come on. Come on. Move along. Come on.
This one.
Come on.
This one.
Come on. Put him in the van. Get a blanket on that one. Come on, back! Right back! Come on!